Saul's servant. And said unto him, I have given unto your master's son all that pertain unto Saul and to all his house. Now therefore, thy sons and thy servants shall till the land for him, and they shall bring him fruits and food to your servant's son. What does he mean? That Ziba man, that strong man, was a mere servant. He wasn't a royal son. But Mephibosheth was a royal son. But he has been pushed away to Lodibar. And that servant has taken his place. If you read further, the Bible says, he has 15 children or 15 sons. 15 sons. Those days, they always record the sons. I don't know how many daughters. A mere servant. Having 15 sons. And how many servants? More than 20. Serving him the servant. And why is the royal son pushed away? All because he was a cripple. Our grandmother Eve. When she fell, we were in her loins. We all fell together. We all became crippled. From that day in Genesis up to when Jesus came, we were all cripples. But when Jesus came, we didn't see ourselves as he, what happened in the garden. But what happened is, he called us onto his table. Whenever he set the table there, he doesn't want you to think back to your old people's state. Here the situation whereby Christians of these days, we run away from the Lord. Amen. It did not end there. David went further and said, but as for you, Mephibosheth,
now who Mephibosheth did?
And verse 12. And Mephibosheth, verse 11, sorry. And the king said to Ziba, according to the king, according to all that the Lord your servants, so shall it be. Everything that belongs to all your father's household shall it be unto you. As for Mephibosheth, said the king, he shall eat continually at my table. Verse 11. He shall eat continually at my table, together with the king's sons.
Amen.
David did not expel the boy.
David the one too.
After restoring everything unto Mephibosheth, he told Ziba,
Ziba,
this boy, he's not an ordinary boy. He is my son. Once and for all. Because of a covenant. So from today henceforth, she is going to sit at my table. And he's going to dine with me. So anytime you are calling him, you are not going to call him Mephibosheth. You are going to call him my son. You are going to call him my son. Because he's no more a cripple. I don't see him a cripple. He's going to sit down and going to eat with me every day. The Bible said continually. Say continually. That means every day. Monday, Wednesday, Tuesday, every day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me give you one revelation. God, from this one in my mind.
See
what is going on here? Imagine I'm the king. She is a cripple. Hello, honey, how are you? You're going to have dinner.
Yeah, Baba, did you?
You have appetite for it?
Come to
good. Where am I looking at? I'm looking at her face.
So
I don't have time to look there and see her crippled legs. I don't see her crippled legs. Because if I go down there, raise the tablecloth, begin to look at their legs, at their crippled feet, my appetite will go away. Jesus, when you come to the lost home, he doesn't see your legs. He looks at you eyeball to eyeball. He opens it and says, my darling, my sugar, we're going to eat. Together with my
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. If you can see the table that he said before and begin to value it, you will never sit down when the Lord's table is being set. A mere person, a human being,
David,
he died.
Oh yeah, David.
After all he did, he died.
Oh yeah, where did you know?
But this time, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, when he died, the Bible tells me, 3 days later, power from on high, lifted him from the grave. Right now, he's at the right hand side of God. He has said this table before you. He doesn't see your crippled legs. He doesn't see the dead dog in you. He doesn't see the human nature you have. But all that he revealed to Paul in Corinthians, tell them, examine themselves. You first know who you are. When you come to the table, you position yourself strategically before the king. Mephibosheth did it. He never remained the same. Today, if you and I will honor the table that our King Jesus has set before you and I and die with him, and during the eating with him, we begin to chat, we begin to talk, things will change. That triple tradition will turn away in the name of Jesus. Remember when I met my wife? I took her to dinner.
And
they woke. Whilst we were walking, she's a very shy person. She couldn't look at me. But the place was so ambiance. It was very nice. Do you often come here? Of course not. He met somebody who shoots her level to the next level. Today, Jesus is going to shoot your level to the next level. When you have the audacity to sit before the king and begin to die with him. Hallelujah. Then I cast my mind back. That day, my wife couldn't finish the food. Excitement. Job. I felt her so much. The same happened to Mephibosheth. When he was before the king, David's table. Oh, he was so joyous. He forgot about all her legs, all his legs. Paul said, examine yourself. That examination, he didn't say change yourself first. So when